My name is Brianna Snyder and I'm a BCBA at DiNovi and Associates. This video is going to talk about Interobserver agreement. When collecting data, how accurate and reliable do you think you are? How often do you check for Interobserver agreement? For most of us, it should probably be more often than we think. The biggest issue in guaranteeing accuracy and reliability of data is human error. Factors that contribute to human error include poorly designed measurement systems, inadequate observer training, and bias towards what the data should reveal. This video will cover the fifth edition task list topic C8. Interobserver agreement, or IOA, is the degree to which two or more independent observers report the same observed values after measuring the same events. It is the most commonly used indicator of measurement quality in ABA. There are many benefits to using IOA as well as various different uses. IOA can serve as a basis for determining the competence of new observers. A newly trained observer should be paired with an experienced, accurate, and reliable observer to ensure that the new observer is measuring the behavior in the same manner as the experienced one. Observer drift can be detected over the course of time or over the course of a study by systematically assessing IOA. For example, if IOA between two observers was high at the beginning of data collection and it has since decreased, observer drift has occurred. IOA data will not show which observer's measurement has drifted, but now further assessment can be conducted to determine if the measurements of the behavior are reliable and accurate. If an observer's measurements are no longer accurate and reliable, they may need to be retrained on proper measurement and IOA will need to be assessed again before continuing to measure a learner's behavior. When two or more observers consistently have high IOA, it shows that the definition of the target behavior is objective, clear, and concise. It also demonstrates that the measurement system of the target behavior is not too complicated. For studies that have multiple observers or for learners who have multiple staff on the case, consistently high levels of IOA show that variability in data are due to actual changes in behavior rather than inaccurate and unreliable data. For example, if staff are collecting data on target behaviors for decrease, there may be some variability in behavior across staff, especially in the beginning stages of plant implementation. IOA data will demonstrate that all observers are collecting data the same way, even though there is some variability in the behavior. By having consistently high levels of IOA, it increases the believability of the data, thus increasing the chances that the data accurately and reliably reflect behavior changes. In order for the assessment of IOA to be valid, it must meet some criteria. There must be at least two observers for IOA to be measured. Observers must be using the same measurement system. This includes the same definitions of the target behavior, observation codes and procedures, and recording devices. All observers need to have received the same training of the measurement system and reach the same level of competence in measuring the target behavior. Observers must be measuring the same events. Observers need to be observing the same learner at the same observation during the same observation intervals. All observers must be positioned so they have a similar view of the learner and the environment in which data are being recorded. The observation period must begin and end at the same time for all observers. If data are obtained from a permanent product, observers do not need to be observing at the same time to assess IOA. Copies of the permanent product should be given to the observer and they are not supposed to see the other observer's scores. Observers need to be independent, meaning one observer should not have influence over another. Procedures should be in place to avoid influence on data collection. For example, observers should not be seated close to one another so that they can compare measurement or talk about the data being recorded. Now that we're familiar with the importance and benefits of IOA, we can talk about the various methods for calculating it. Percentage of IOA is the most common form of reporting IOA, as this makes it easy for everyone to be able to interpret. With that being said, there are various methods to calculate percent IOA. IOA can be calculated for data obtained through event recording. To calculate IOA, total count IOA, mean count per interval IOA, exact count per interval IOA, and trial by trial IOA can be used. IOA can also be calculated for data obtained through timing. Timing includes duration, response latency, and inter-response time. IOA is calculated similarly to event recording. To calculate IOA, total duration IOA and mean duration per occurrence IOA are used. Additionally, IOA can be calculated for data obtained through interval recording and time sampling. IOA can be found by calculating interval by interval IOA, scored interval IOA, and unscored interval IOA. Interval by interval IOA overestimates the actual IOA between observers when measuring behaviors that occur at very high or very low rates. Scored interval IOA calculates the percentage of intervals in which one or both of the observers recorded an occurrence of behavior. Low rates. It is recommended that this IOA be used when behaviors occur during less than 30% of intervals. Unscored interval IOA calculates the intervals in which one or both of the observers recorded a non-occurrence of the target behavior. Unscored interval IOA provides a more accurate assessment of IOA for behaviors that occur at high rates. It is recommended that unscored interval IOA be used for behaviors that occur during more than 70% of intervals. Many things should be considered when choosing, recording, and reporting IOA. When conducting a study, IOA should be assessed during each phase and condition. Overall, whether in a study or when conducting regular sessions with learners, IOA should be assessed across days of the week, time of day, observers, and settings. The frequency that IOA will be assessed will be determined based on prior IOA results, the complexity of the measurement system, the experience and number of observers, and the number of phases and conditions. IOA calculation methods should be determined based on the measurement system and the data set. More precise and conservative methods should be used rather than methods that overestimate IOA. At the very least, observers should have an IOA of 80%. There is no scientific reasoning behind it. Researchers and clinicians have typically been using this number as a good rule of thumb. But the closer to 100% IOA, the more believable the data. IOA can be reported as a narrative, in a table, or in a graph. Overall, the goal is to ensure that whomever is reading the report on the IOA will be able to understand it. Thanks for watching. If you'd like some more content, please subscribe.